Welcome back. In this video, I'm going to talk about validation rules. So, what is a validation rule? Validation rule is a set of rules which we can apply on any column that we need. And it helps us to restrict data entry for this columns. So, here we have this table. We have ID, employee name, date of birth, salary, discount percentage, email address, and the last one, gender. So I want to apply a validation rule on these columns. So the first one, the employee name. Our problem with employee name is that the user can enter names, but he also can enter numbers and special characters. Look, and it will automatically save it. How can we control it and letting only enter letters and spaces without numbers and special characters? So in this case, we go to design, and but let me delete this. Okay, design, employee name. Here we have validation rule. We can right click, build. Here we write the validation. Okay, so we wrote it. Let's save it. Save. Yes, we want to save the changes and go to view. Here let's write boolean. It saves without any problem. But what if I try to write number 8 and go to next step? It will not allow, because it says you set a validation which don't allow to entering numbers. The same thing for any special character, it will not save it. But the problem is here, the message is not clear for the user. He don't understand what is wrong. So it's better if you change this message to something understandable. So how can we do it? We go to design, click on employee name. Here we set the validation rule, and we can set the validation text. For example, we can write only letters are allowed. Okay, so this time let's enter 7, and it says only letters are allowed. So we customized the message. Okay, now date of birth. Our problem with date of birth is the user can select the date which is greater than today. For example, he can select tomorrow, which is not correct. So how can we avoid it? We go to, first let me delete this. And then we go to design, date of birth, and we write the validation rule for date. We write is null or less or equal to date. And here we can write date of birth must be smaller than or equal to today. Let's save it. And now if I select any date, it will accept it. But what if I select tomorrow? It will not accept it, and it says date of birth must be smaller or equal to today. Okay. What about salary? Here in salary, we can write, for example, $1,000, but also we can write $1 million. As well, we can write minus $150, which for us, maybe it's not correct. We want the range between zero and, for example, $10,000. So how can we set the validation for number? The same thing, we go to design, salary, And here the validation rule, we write between 0 and $10,000. And in the text we can also write salary must be between 0 and $10,000. Let's save it. Yes. Yeah. Okay. So let's write 1,000. It will accept it. But if we write -250, it will not allow, and it says salary must be between $0 and $10,000. The same thing for $1 million, it will not accept it. But what if I want to allow all the positive numbers but don't allow the negative? So in this case we go to the validation and we can write greater or equal to zero. We just write greater or equal to zero. Yep, we save it. And now it should work. If we write any positive number, it will accept it, but not negative numbers. For discount, the same thing. We set the validation between 0 and 100. For email, now we can enter anything, but what we want the data or the text for email address should be something at domain.com. So the syntax should be like this. So how can you set the syntax for email address? The same thing, we go to design, email address, validation rule, build, and you write this code. Okay, save it. Yes. Now let's try anything. If you type it, it will not accept it because the syntax is incorrect. What if we write anything at domain.com? It will accept it. For example, at gmail.com. It will accept it because there is something, there is a text, and there is at after that gmail or any provider .com or .net. For gender, let's say we have male and female, and we don't want the user to enter any other text than male or female or M or F. So how can we set the text here in validation rule? We can write M or F. Okay, save it. Yes. Yes. Now in gender, if you write any letter, it will not accept it. Only M or F. M for male, F for female. Or we can say M or F or male or female. Now it accepts male, female, M, F. You can write F or you can write female. You can write M or you can write male. So that is it for validation rules. It helps a lot for entering data and setting validation.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos and let me know what you think in comment section.